Well, all this morning we've been telling you about the breaking news that has happened, also some very sad news. The retired Archbishop Philip Hannan has passed away. He passed away at 3 o'clock this morning. He was the 11th Archbishop for the city of New Orleans. He died at 98 years old. Just to give you a little background, a little information on Hannan, he was the Archbishop of New Orleans for about two full decades, and he certainly leaves an unmatched legacy for the folks here and for the Catholic Archdiocese in New Orleans. He was a remarkable man. He was Catholic to the core. He was a friend to the poor, certainly into the rich as well. He was here and in place for several presidents and for popes. He served as a powerful icon in the city, but more importantly, he was there for the powerless and for the homeless as well. Many will tell you that he was a Renaissance man to many people of all faiths and those of no faith at all. If you'll recall, a crowning achievement of Hannan's almost two dozen years as Archbishop was his personal role in organizing the visit by the Pope. That was in 1987. That was Pope John Paul II. He was with him on the altar of the St. Louis Cathedral. That's how close those two had become over time. In fact, they were so close that he rode with him in the Popemobile during the motorcade through the city. But this wasn't the only papal connection. He also followed John Paul to Cuba on his 1998 visit there. A lot of people want to know what has happened. We are efforting phone interviews with the New Orleans Archdiocese, so as soon as we get them on the line, of course, we'll bring it to you live. Hannan was appointed Archbishop for the city of New Orleans back in 1965. This, as you'll recall, is the city was really reeling and trying to clean up or rebuild from Hurricane Betsy. He immediately took part in the emergency operations during that storm. He personally got out and inspected the disastrous storm damage. He went out and tried to help people rebuild their lives. He was very active in trying to rebuild the Catholic schools at that time. He even wrote a book. He was very active well into his 90s. Another thing that Hannan did during his time as Archbishop here, he created a food bank. And you'll know it best as the Second Harvest Food Bank, feeding countless and thousands of people in need by providing free food and items. You can imagine that thoughts and condolences are coming in fast and furiously. We want to go now to WDSU reporter Rosa Flores, who's monitoring all the comments that you all are bringing into our newsroom. Rosa?
Well, Camille, a lot of thoughts and condolences definitely throughout the social media scene, both on Facebook and on Twitter. I pulled some of the Twitter thoughts. Take a look at your screen. This is from Sophia. She says, retired New Orleans Archbishop Hannan has passed away at the age of 98. He lived such a long and amazing life. Here's another message. Delivered the homily during JFK's funeral mass. Again, a lot of folks remembering a lot of the things that he did throughout his life. Rashad says, former New Orleans Archbishop Philip M. Hannan, confidant of JFK, defender of the unborn. If you would like to share some of your condolences, just post them on our Facebook page or on Twitter, and we could read them right here on WDSU. Camille, back to you.
And just to piggyback on what that viewer wrote into us, you'll recall that when Bobby Kennedy was assassinated, Hannan returned to Washington for his graveside eulogy. And it was a really, really, really big deal. So again, the breaking news and very sad news for you this morning, 3 o'clock this morning, the 11th Archbishop for the city of New Orleans passed away. Family at his bedside. His health had been deteriorating for the past year, more specifically just in the past few days. A man who was very active, well into his 90s, and led this city with just a remarkable man.